Who was your first crush?
Finished!
There's no way anyone actually answered.
No comments.
Me and Tori used to get harassed after school on the train to tell everybody what our crushes were.
I don't think you'll admit.
Funny.
You have to be honest.
Oh, guys, they want to know.
Wait.
3, 2, 1, top.
First crush.
Begins with L.
That's got to be.
Ends with
A.
Moana.
No, what about Z? Oh,
that's clever.
No, year 12 onwards, bro.
That's clever. You said Moana. That's indirect. That's
Caleb, who was yours?
When I was in year 7 doing the Olave production, there was this year 13 at the time called Daniel.
Daniela.
Oh, is it? Alright, that one.
Someone in the year above.
Mine's Daniel as well.
What? Lily's guys.
Wow, that is far.
I don't know.
One to your imaginary girlfriend, you have an imaginary crush as well.
Oh, yeah,
H. H is me.
I think it's quite obvious. You know who you are.
Yeah, I think it's obvious for me as well. Yeah, it's obvious for me too, I think. No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
There was some girl from my church called Princess. That was it. The niggas making up names now.
No, what? That's what you were sad.
Shut up.
And
we
also have her boyfriend at the time.
Yeah, her boyfriend, so that doesn't even count.
I'm not gonna say.
It was a mistaken one. They don't know that it was them. Yeah. But then I realised it was a mistake later on, but it shall remain non-disclosed. But was my first proper not mistaken crush.
His first crush was Miguel.
And
it was
both
of
them.
Oh shit,
yeah,
my first crush.
But that was
before.
But
Luke
and
Daryl was your top three.
That was like before I
came
to A-Labs on like, when was it?
Yeah. I remember.
I'm just on my grind, you know.
Shut up, bro.
Answer for me, I don't
care.
That's
first crush. Lily has a fish card and it still carries on.
That's good.
No, it wasn't Tanisha.
No, we've got evidence.
You're moving nuts.
It was
Hannah or Tanisha?
It was definitely Tanisha.
No, no, no,
no.
I plead the fifth.
No.
Can you say who it is?
Oh, no.
If you ever want to
look at
him.
I'm going
to say who it is. You just don't explain it.
I don't explain it. Can we move on to the next question?
No, because I only said it.
Didn't have a crush.
Not even me.
Sad life, guys.
He's emotionless guy.
Play the sad music in there, zoom in his face. Tears drop going down. Grey.
Sad face.
Yeah, zoom in his face. That has to be zoomed in.
Go to play Pokemon Go.
Yeah.
Oh look! It's a Pokemon!
On my phone!
Oh,
slap! Is that Pikachu around? What's that rustling? Oh no! Where is everyone? Guys? Something's coming down. Oh no!
You're so bad at
Where's
James gone?
Oh yeah, where's James?
Okay, let's split up and go and find
it. I'll go this way, you guys go that way.
I'll go that way.
Okay, bye. What's that? What's that? James! Where are you, James? James! Ah!
Ah! Rishi! James! Kieran! Ah! Ah! Ah!
What's your best moment?
Every moment's the best moment with you guys.
That's moist, man.
Crash. Two trades of four speed collided.
South Africa for sure, I think.
Yeah.
South Africa was a fun time, guys.
I think winning the Kent Cup, that was a big one.
That was a big one.
That's crazy.
I think for me, just like all the stupid practicals we did, how much we messed up during like chemistry practicals and biology practicals.
Probably world challenge in Croatia, tipping over the lock.
Oh, my chemistry lesson was every day, Harry.
Hiding behind the bushes during cross country.
Cabaret, 100%.
Our best moment was Cabaret.
My best moment is the first ever time wearing the senior prefect robes. And me and Io walked past every single science block classroom like,
I remember seeing you.
Yeah, I'm always so cool.
Oh,
Antigua.
Probably Antigua. Watching Ishkov devour Grace Hines' face.
Second name as well, you're moving nuts.
That's two. You haven't got two left.
Oh, that's crazy.
I don't remember that happening to his mom and dinner.
My favourite memory has to be placing the CD drive in Amelia's car because it was broken for so long. We ended up having to like break the car and try fixing it. So we're trying to force like different CDs into the CD jack and like turning on the engine, switching off again, and like just spamming all the buttons until it finally took one of those bits out again.
I gotta say it was Black History Month. I came out swagged out in my
traditional
club, you know what I'm saying?
For us, FNL.
Oh yeah,
that's a fact.
Yeah.
What me? Oh, probably just cricket.
Alright, cool.
What does FNL stand for if the viewers don't know?
If you are the viewers, sir.
Come on, man. Okay. Explain it.
Friday Night Lights.
Friday Night Lights.
Yeah!
Oh, yeah, that was it.
No, my best moments were when we were alone in the common room and everyone else had gone. And we used to just, like, fuck
after
around.
School.
Yeah. We're not allowed to wear our own. Oh yeah, we used to just fuck around in the common room. And it was really, really nice.
And then you realised there was there. Cameras in the
lockers and like and then one day Dami looked up and she saw there's a
camera.
Yeah,
yeah.
And then we were having a contact.
Yes, we
had
a contact in that room.
I was Beyonce. She was obviously Michelle.
Beyonce slash Kelly.
Beyonce Kelly.
Beyonce me.
Probably some of the drive to school would be
funny
as hell. And hearing people's like singing voices. Gotta love that.
Carpool karaoke.
Yeah.
Like carpool karaoke to One Direction with the windows open.
Yeah.
Past all the assembly.
Yeah. Gotta love that.
It's just like random lessons where you just had like the funniest banter.
Yeah.
That was like the best bit.
No, I'm trying to remember like something that's actually.
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Physics like, lessons.
Something else. All day gave means day.
Physics lessons
with
chill. James. Stuart. Tori and Bonnie. That was.
I think Cabaret was really good, but I really like helping do the auditions, like watching everyone perform and seeing like how good people was actually quite interesting.
Probably on Bush, but I think we call it Anton.
No, it didn't happen. Favourite moment?
Oh yeah, Antigua as well. I was just saying I quite enjoyed these guys. They made documentaries of the trip.
Oh yeah, those documentaries were
the wild love documentary.
Dr. Rashford called Sack at Pathetic.
Oh, what's her name? What's that awful name?
Miss Eugene!
Do you remember that happened when we were talking yet? And then she came over to us.
Man was learning line dance and shuffle routines with Carrie. Performed every morning for like a little show tried in boost.
Women's.
That was done.
Sorry.
Women.
Oh, no.
Wednesday.
Boys, boys, boys.
No,
it
could be that. Rugby coaches.
Ooh! And when you got piss in your mouth.
Okay, yeah, that's the best one, bro. Rugby coaches, rugby coaches.
Woo! For me, it's probably got to be when they announced Olaf should get sacked.
Independence Day.
Sorry to disturb you on close of day. In the light of this, and in order to protect the integrity of the investigation,
He's gone.
The head teacher has been suspended from all responsibilities as headmaster of the school.
Embarrassing moment.
My first. Wait, what?
Embarrassing
my
moment.
Embarrassing moment is named as Lily Squared. Classic.
Oh, Ishak crying when he got 98% of the test because he lost two silly marks.
My one's outside of the
pavilion. Oh,
yeah!
That's a good one.
Tori got attacked outside the pavilion and everyone was watching.
The kid won't be attacked, guys.
Maybe just now.
We have to say it though.
Nah.
Sam was the bad trip.
No.
He had an imaginary girlfriend.
He had an imaginary girlfriend for the whole of your night.
That's it.
Tell the camera. What was her name?
I swear you and her got matching shoes.
He had four pairs of shoes and wrote H and M on the bottom.
Oh my.
He also took out for dinner and ate his patient and was waiting that his food was actually taking too long to cut.
What about Ollie? Oh, pants in the school, full dong stank.
Yeah, how about that?
Yeah, first day of year 12.
What?
It was year 12 induction day, yeah? We all fancy him, bro, thinking this guy's wearing pants or something. Just put out, his dong comes out.
You ripped in that hole.
I don't know who did that.
Yo, that's pretty good.
What an introduction to year 12.
Ooh, Newstead.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
Those are our saying, yeah.
So Mika, would that be your banana slip?
I don't know. I mean, I played rugby one time.
That wasn't embarrassing.
It was embarrassing because it was like we were running. rugby, right? And then it was with like all the massive year 13s. We were back in year 12. And I proper like bodied onto the floor and like slid all over the ground. It was really embarrassing. That's the first time.
Oh, I tripped up the stairs, but I fell flat on my face, and everyone just looked at me and was like, are you okay? And I was like, yeah.
Windmill.
What? Rabbies is the hurricane issue, so Aronov noticed a certain pattern in his head and decided to point that out in front of all of the boys, and he still doesn't really take that down.
Anton puking in the science block.
Well, in school, I don't have anything. Okay, well,
lost
into
Mac
today, same guy.
In year 7, I brought in a picture of my rabbit.
I'll send you the picture,
Joe. No, I'm good, I'm good.
I think mine has to be, I was walking past a set of windows and I wanted to check how I look. And then I realised when I walked past that there were a few people in there.
Fine, when my wig got pulled off, okay? Moving on, next question!
Mine has to be missing the kick in front of the post and crying about it in year 7. So, it was year 7, we all have mistakes.
So Alan's, he once wrote a poem.
Oh yes!
Are these the fight over the same girl?
When something like, my heart melts.
My heart melts like
dearest Lilia, I will!
It was
I was
when you
fight, can I read it?
Read it. So remember, Alan had not met this girl yet.
On Instagram.
I haven't even spoken to her.
Never seen her in real life.
I know you made this a joke. Get frank.
Right, so the context of this is that Alan had never met this girl before, but he liked her. And so he wrote her a poem.
Hey, I know we don't know each other that
well.
But I want you to know that as soon as I saw you, my heart melted. When you smile, I feel like smiling. You're really nice. Honestly, you make my world. Please say yes.
You make my world. Did you hear that? You make my world.
Please say yes.
Are we saying who that's to?
No, that's
already
said it.
I already said it.
There we go, it's got said.
There are many great art galleries across London. Tate Modern, The Serpentine. But there is one place harder for an artist to get their work. The Pavilion. Now, I've spent months in the Pavilion, analysing every inch and drawing up all my plans because I knew there was something I could exploit. A hole in the wall, right there. A gap which has no reason to be empty, so why would anyone question it? I knew I had to get my piece in unnoticed, so to get it past year 13, I did it during games. But there remained another problem. Mr. Holland's office is directly opposite where I needed to be, so I had to be patient. I waited for 3 hours until I knew he was busy, and finally, I pounced. The Pavilion, home of Olaf's sporting greats. Teams of the past, the rugby captains, and now, me.
What will you miss most?
Probably miss centre, aren't
Lunch time's in the pavilion and canteen.
Sports days.
Miss Ward, I will miss.
Miss Ward.
She.
I miss Miss
Chef's
Nice.
Kiss.
I love Miss.
I miss Miss Nice.
Absolutely.
Nice.
Nice.
Oh, no. Yeah.
Mornings, getting Costa.
It's just buzz.
Rapping.
Freestyle.
Oh, sports day was gone.
Sports day's work.
What did you compete in?
Nah, Saturday morning rugby.
I was got javelin as well, actually.
Coach Journey's playing.
Oh, yeah, I hit javelin 9 times in a row.
Coach Journey's a rugby or cold.
I will miss laughing at Mick, what's her name with you?
The English.
Miss Sullivan.
Oh.
And her clothing choices.
I
will miss the ability to learn at this great institution. It would be so heartbreaking.
Hey, stop it, man.
You're Sikh, man.
I don't know the one for Sikh.
I'll say football. Being in front of the football team.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, and I feel like what's been really good about year 13 is I can just kind of go into the pub and sit down next to anyone and be like, hey, how are you?
Yeah.
And have a conversation, and I think I'll miss that a lot.
I miss the weekend.
We all will.
Being at Olaf's made the weekend that much more better. Because I realized what was going on. Yeah. It felt like hell.
But
I think I'll miss the events that I had to put on, like Cabaret and that sort of thing.
Yeah, I think we'll see everyone in the morning and like post up as well.
I enjoyed captaining it though.
The basketball team.
Yeah.
What?
Have you got a memorable game?
Memorable game?
Yeah.
I dropped like 25. Okay. It was alright.
Against you.
Seven tournaments.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Whole day of missing.
Whole day, seven tournaments.
I was coming.
You go.
Yeah, unlucky now.
My go.
I said, did you go?
To what?
I wasn't in the team.
Sevens. Did you go to sevens? Man like you, come on. You're cold, bro.
You didn't have to say that loud. It's just a conversation between me and you. Come on.
Just having random conversations with random people that like you won't talk to, like,
yeah.
On the day.
I like that you can talk to anyone.
Yeah.
Okay.
The physics department.
We've got the electives, they don't have
time. I think it's the vibe, like just
not like the school. Like you see that chemistry, you see the science department. I'm so excited to just wait and never get back.
Our peers, we'll miss our peers as well. Here's no Morgan.
Alan, I know, three words to summarize your life at Olave's.
Basically, cricket, brothers, fun.
Thumb.
Extreme depression, mild.
Big man, I said three words, so I don't know why you're there for.
Three words. Fun, sad, enjoyable overall.
I said three words!
I know. Okay. Overly fun, mild depression.
I said three words!
Yeah,
that was what?
You're not gonna get three.
Oh my god, that's why you're getting cut out.
Lil Punch, aka Nanak Kunjan. Three words, please.
Nanak. Three words, by the way. Don't do the thing that Annie did and say five words or some shit. Yeah, I want three words. One, two, three. Bing, bang, bow.
Olaves are babes.
That is the coldest one I've heard yet.
James, follow me here. We're doing a little interview. Lads, and girls, and everyone. Three words to sum up Olaves.
Bro, do you think I think of three words right now?
You're dead. Tanisha, she's lost. Three words to sum up Olaves.
I think everyone is trash.
That is not three words. You're dead. Wait.
Hashtag bleed purple.
Hashtag bleed purple. The coldest I've ever heard yet.
Josh.
What, three words?
Three words.
Okay, so I'm going to go with... It was pretty fun, you know, fun, interesting, and awful.
Because I'm a sick interviewer. Don't chat. Come on the camera and do your three words properly.
Okay, in three words, describe your Olaf's experience.
I already said it. I said cricket, my brothers, and fun.
You're forgetting your lack of girlfriends.
Oh,
okay. He's a hoe. He's a hoe.
He said lack.
So basically, guys, that's the end of the interview. Have fun.
Who's your favourite teacher?
That's right. Miss Donald.
Miss me. Miss Johnson.
Send the right thing.
Mrs. Ward.
Yeah, that's Mr.
Bassett.
Mr.
Bassett.
Mr.
Bassett.
Mr.
Bassett.
Mr. Bassett.
Mr. Bassett.
Mr.
Bassett.
Mr.
Bassett.
Mr. Bassett. Mr. Bassett.
Mr. Greenwood.
Millions was different.
That was close. Mr. Greenwood.
Mr. Lane.
No one.
Donald.
Oh, ho, ho, ho.
No.
Sorry,
I can't.
Yeah, that has to be clipped out.
That's getting kept.
Mr. Fazzaranti.
Mr.
Bassett.
The whole PE department, the whole history department, and Dr. Stewart.
Oh, Dr. Carpenter.
Miss Eugene was my favourite teacher.
That was my favourite teacher, Dr. Stewart.
Maybe.
Mr.
Archibald was a whole new level.
Yeah.
Mr. Kenwood,
go.
No, Mr. Worst.
Mr. Worst.
Go.
What?
Miss Claire, could you just say that name?
Yeah,
man.
I love
Miss
Smith.
Miss Smith.
Mr.
Smith. And it has to be Joseph. I think Mr. Bassett.
Miss
Difford.
Miss Anoratney.
Oh, Miss Anoratney.
Miss Smith.
Dr. Batista.
Mr.
Thomas. Oh.
Mr. Gray. I'm back with this decision. Mr. Greenwood. Yeah. Or Mr. Masters. Or the old Mr. Archer.
Yeah.
Probably Mr. Hanks,
because
he's doing like really good role being in economics.
Mr. Bassett, Mr. Lee when he was back here, Mr. Spiel.
No. Oh, that's the one. What was that rugby coach? Yeah. Oh, yeah, Mr. Gonzalez.
Mr. Safiji, remember?
Yeah, Mr. Safiji, yeah, that's
it. Oh, I like Mr. Jason. Oh, Mr. Naratni. Mr. Naratni.
Oh, Mr. Naratni. Of course.
Oh, Mr. Fazzaranti.
Fazzaranti.
Why are you violent, dude?
He's a nice guy.
Mr. Hines. Mr. Hines is a chef.
Mr.
Hines.
Dr. Amatista.
Dr. Amatista!
I think Dr. Stewart is good.
Anyone in the physics department that taught me.
Mr. Taspero. Who else is a good
Miss
Smith.
Yes, that's
what I
love
it. I think Mr.
Bugs. Yeah. Mr. Greenwood as well. Mr. Greenwood is so funny. Yeah. Yeah. In a weird way, you're going to rush me. In a weird way, I find Miss Johnson cute.
Yeah.
Like, with her, it's like 50% of the time I really like her.
She is.
Hello, and thank you for letting me add my thoughts and reflections to your Leavers video. As a sixth form led by an outstanding senior prefect team, you are a wonderful body of young adults who have enhanced the school life by organising brilliant events such as Cultural Awareness Day, Black History Month and Festival. Many of you will be remembered for your thoughtful comments in lessons, your energy around school, and your participation in the many clubs and societies that have happened despite the lockdown. All of your achievements, both co-curricular and academic, reflect your hard work, your talent and determination, alongside the support of your parents and a committed, dedicated staff. I hope you will look back at your years at St. Olave's as happy and successful. Please do not be afraid to let us know about your successes and even your failures. Your place in the history of the school may fade, but you will not be forgotten by the staff who have taught you during your time here. So the next stage of your future, after school and beyond, now lies in front of you like a blank page. There is so much in front of you. The promises, the possibilities, the mysteries, the adventures. That blank page just lying there, daring you to write on it. Good luck, all the best, and I hope to see you again soon.
Thank you so much, Year 13, for all your hard work over the last 2 years. It's been a pleasure to be your head of year. You've shown real patience, perseverance and resilience throughout this time. Some highlights for me are just the day-to-day conversations that I have with many of you and also the cook-along that we did under lockdown. I want to wish you every success going forward. You will have got a lot stronger from this experience, and I hope that the world is much kinder to you in the future.
Okay, hi there, Year 13. It's been a pleasure being your assistant head of year for the last 2 years. It has to be said, it's been the strangest 2 years you can possibly imagine, with the COVID pandemic disrupting just about everything we've been doing. It makes it difficult to pick out some of the traditional high spots from the year, because some of the extracurricular stuff has been missing. We haven't been able to go to CERN, for example, with the physics department, which is a tragedy. But nevertheless, I think the year group is to be congratulated enormously on how you've dealt with the COVID challenge. Certainly the classes I've taught throughout both lockdowns and either side of that, I've not ceased to be hugely impressed with your commitment, the amount of effort, the attendance levels at offline lessons, which have essentially been 100% the whole time as far as I can see. That's been very difficult for some of you, I know, but enormously to your credit, and I think the resilience that you have learned by struggling through these challenges will stand you in very good stead for the future. So it's not been the easiest of 2 years, but it has been fun. It's been a pleasure getting to know as many of you as I have done. I have no doubt that whatever the form of the assessments this summer, you're all going to do exceptionally well in them. Students from this school always do. And you're going to go on to great, interesting and exciting things. So I wish you all the very best. Good luck for the future. And it's been a pleasure looking after you. Thank you very much.
Okay, Year 13s. I would just like to say that it's been an absolute pleasure teaching all of the Year 13s I've been able to teach this year. But when I think about this year group, actually, I'm quite fortunate that I got to teach people last year, and even further still, my Year 10 and 11 class, who we won't go into details about, but we're a very silly billy class. But it just has been so nice to think of all the Year 13s I've managed to get to know over the course of the last 4 years. It has this year been a roller coaster of everything, emotions, academically, but it will really build you with the most patience and resilience you will need to be able to cope with life. And so in some ways we can look at it as a blessing in disguise, and it will really build you for what you need to do further and later in life. I can truly say that there are some definite characters in this year group, some quiet characters, some funny characters, some cheeky ones, some annoying ones, but for me, I think what's most important is that you really stay true to yourself. I think there'll be many ways in which you may be pulled and dragged to change who you are, but what makes you great is that you are all individually the best characters. And so please, as you go into the future, do not change, stay true to yourself. And lastly, I just want to wish you good luck. Okay, good luck with everything that you do, and please stay in touch. Bye.
So, Year 13, it's been an emotional roller coaster ever since I took you over as head of year for you boys who are the older Olavians from right the way from Year 10 to Year 13. How time flies. Just wanted to wish you all, and that is all of you, the very best for your futures, whether that's university or going down an apprenticeship or employment route. Just so many good memories from ranging from the South Africa tour, which many of the rugby boys will be a part of, to many assemblies, moments shared, memories gained. Just want to wish you all the very best for the future. And yes, even you, Martin Guri, I do wish you all the very best. Stay in touch, guys, and good luck for your mocks and have the summer of your lives. You deserve it. Cheers, guys.
Okay, hello, everyone. I brought this very special memento, which is a bottle of Iron Brew, which was given to me by 11N 2 years ago, and I've still kept it, because it's full sugar, can't get them anymore. So just a few names from that: Nicholas, Harry, Alessandro, Isaac, Mika, Nikita, Rafi, Henry, Cameron. Thank you very much for this. And of course, I've got the touching tribute that was given to me by Ed Foxhall at the end of Year 11, when he said in his card, "Sir, thank you for teaching us." I didn't really understand a word, but it was fun. So thanks for that, Ed. Thank you to all of you. Thanks to everyone, the people that we taught in lower school, people that have joined in sixth form. And I'd like to take this opportunity to wish you all the best for your future. Stay in touch and good luck to everyone.
Hi everyone, as I'm being forced to do this for you all, which I find quite difficult as you can see, wishing you all the very, very best for your futures, whatever you may do. You've been a joy to spend time with, all of you. Enjoy all your ventures in life and be really proud of what you've all achieved. I am sure you'll have a great future ahead of you. Always be kind to yourself and others, but most of all, best of luck and have fun. See you later.
Hello Year 13, just wanted to say good luck, you've made it, well done, and I really do wish you the best luck for September, whatever that brings for you.
Best of luck guys, you deserve all the success that you're going to have as you become real adults now, although you can probably milk it for a few more years of only being teenagers. It's been so lovely getting to teach and know so many of you over the last 2 years. You've really made my first 2 years at Olav super memorable, and I really genuinely wish you all the best. You so, so deserve it.
Right, Year 13. I would really like to take this opportunity to wish you the very best of luck for the future and tell you what a wonderful year group you've been. But I can't. Well, I can for most of you. This is a message only directed at a select few. For those people who are in the under 13B and under 14B rugby teams, I want my Saturday mornings back. That's time that I lost in my life, having to watch you guys, I was going to say play rugby, but that would be a loose definition of the word, which would probably upset some of the PE staff. And probably second and most importantly, and you know who you are for this one, when Southampton lose in the future, because yes, I know they will lose, please don't contact me. I'm not interested. Your teams, I hope, will lose far more than Southampton will. On a more serious note, though, I do genuinely wish you the very best of luck for the upcoming months for university and for your futures as well.
Hello Year 13, it's Mr. Gonzalez here, and some of you remember me from when I taught you in Year 7. Thanks so much for James for getting in touch and allowing me the opportunity to wish you all luck. I still have very fond memories of your year group. I remember a very bright year group, cheeky at times, but one which I'm sure will go on to do great things. So very good luck for the future.
Thank you.
Describe your best moment in Olav's.
When we went into lockdown in year 12 was probably the highlight.
Well, wait, so you're saying that the best moment...
Estelle, we're about to get down.
Get down. Just touch down in London town.
Bail the biggest skate you know.
Well, what?
Bail the biggest skate you know.
The show.
Delete that right now. No comment. They're lying. They're just violating the thing.